So this is the first massage video I've done in a few weeks when Maria was over here for the second time. And today I have Michelle from Infinite Hope here to help with the socialization process because it's been going very slowly for me. She's progressed in many different ways, but when it comes time for me to actually reach out to her and try to touch her, she is terrified and runs away from me. Otherwise, she's happy and playing all around me and is having a good time here, but she's just not letting me be a part of her happiness. But as you can see here, once we get her out and in between my legs here and doing massage on her, she's really enjoying it. And she could easily run away from me right now, but as has been the case with each time that we've done this, she stays with me. And lets me do this. She is purring very softly. But I just keep thinking, you'd think that she'd remember this. And let me do more. But there's something about when I'm here alone, it's a whole different game. When I have someone here helping me, like Basha, Maria, and now Michelle, it's a whole different story.
So content.
Yeah. It's been this way each time. And if you remember in the videos, she was like this on the very first day she arrived. And I thought, oh, well, this is going to be really easy. It's just, I just can't figure it out.
Like you said, she could easily scurry away right now.
She could. In fact, last time I slowed the massage down and just had my hands lightly on her. And I was curious to see how long she would stay with me. She stayed for quite a long time. Hmm. And then she finally just slowly moved out of my hands. I mean, in her eyes, there's still some caution. It's like I'm really liking this, but what's going to happen next? Hey, sweetie, it's okay. It's all right. Yeah. You relax.
Does she ever, when she's out and about, does she ever, like, fully stretch out?
Oh, stretch out. And, you know, attacking her toys.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm around. I might be sitting at my desk, but she'll be, you know, sometimes she'll just be a few feet away from me and just really tackling her toys, or just rolling around in a catnip high.
Uh-huh.
Having a great time. I mean, really having a great time. She's just so happy. And
when she moves about, she's like standing up straight. She's not slinking.
It depends on my location and proximity to her. Sometimes it's like a partial crouch. But not all the time. I mean, I see her moving about, and I think more lately, like I said, she's getting a little bolder and coming out when I'm nearby, but if I walked right toward her, then she would run away.
Yeah.
But all those little signs, it keeps getting better and better and better, except for this one area of me being able to
reach out.
To do this, to reach out, to pick her up, to handle her. She's just not having it. Whereas all of the other signs show progress.
Yeah.
And it just doesn't match up for me. It just doesn't make any sense. But when someone else is here, the dynamic changes. And we can get her to do things like this. If I could only have the opportunity to do this every day, I think she'd be a very different cat right now. But the main thing is that at least she's happy here, and she feels she can play and eat and take treats from me. I mean, she come right up to me for the treats. It's getting to the point now, just recently, where she can be in her safe spot away from me, and I will sit in here in this area And I just shake the bag, and it's like, oh, treats, and she'll come out. Mm-hmm. But then when if I reach out to touch her during any of this, then she's gone.
She looks like she could fall asleep.
Yeah. Hear the purr. It's very soft. Before I just felt it, now I can hear it a little bit.
I can't. Like she was considering her options there.
Yes.
She was looking around.
Yes. It's about that time. And in fact, I'll just let her go when she's ready. Just having the little trough of my legs too is probably sending her a little bit into a more relaxed state.
Yeah, she seems quite content.
Yeah. You know, Danci, I'd benefit from this too. It's not easy having a cat around and not being able to snuggle or touch. Yeah. I have to.
It's frustrating.
I have to go over and get my cat fix from Basha and her cats. Which I do anyway, but I'm so glad I have that to fall back on.
Rumbles
going now we're on. Now we're going, yeah.
got a little bit of biscuit making going on in the front.
She's good at that. She's just pretty still right now. Well, she flinches a little bit there. But what do you think, sweetie? You seem to like that. You seem pretty comfortable. Yeah. It's me back here. What you gonna do? It's like I want to go, but I want to stay.
She seems a little conflicted.
And it just adds to the, there we go. So she just went to hide under that cat tree. She doesn't even come over into this area. There's that bed. There's that bed over there, which I got specifically for her. She has never even recognized them as beds. She never comes over here. Hey, baby. Danci. Danci, honey, everything's okay. Think?
She really pushes against that.
Yeah, she does. Now see, you're you're working on her more vigorously than what I'm used to, and she really seems to enjoy that. Which some cats do, not all.
No, exactly.
She likes it.
I'm pushing her a little bit.
She likes
it. Like,
yeah.
Some cats would not tolerate this.
Yes.
And
she likes it.
And sometimes I feel like that kind of, for cats that like it, it can push them out of their nervous place.
Mm-hmm.
Because it riles them, you know, like it riles them out of their nervous brain.
General mode of working is slow and rhythmic and precise, but that doesn't mean I ever rule out this kind of vigorous work because it definitely has its place.
I was trying to get it on the belly a little bit there.
She doesn't seem to mind.
No.
Look at that. Yeah, she's just. She's giving in. Whoa. Good girl.
She's purring.
Yeah.
I think it's also a little bit like remnant of a play, like a wrestle that cats would do with each other.
Right.
When you're kind of just doing a more vigorous touch. It's a different kind of touch, obviously.
Mm-hmm.
Than... All right.
Very good, Danci. So now what's going to happen when Michelle leaves and you're here alone with me again?
Danci, it is nice to see you.